I hope you're ready for this. I hope more than 5 of you showed up. I hope that I can get in to get my hair fixed. Hi, welcome back to my channel. If you've never been here before, that's not surprising. Today we're doing something a little bit different. I understand you have some cooking tips for us, Diane. We are resting comfortably in our 90s and early 2000s nostalgia. So if you were around during that time, you were a teenager during that time, I think you'll really appreciate this video. If you were not, if you were older, younger, not born yet, God, I'm old. This video could also be for you too, because it's gonna be fun. It's gonna be fun.
I understand you've got some cooking tips for us, Diane.
So we're gonna start with a get ready with me, and then we're gonna get into taking a deeper look into nostalgia from the year 2001, May 2001, pre 9/11, 2001, with Teen People's The 25 Hottest Stars Under 25 edition. I had a subscription to this magazine. Remember when we used to subscribe to magazines? But we can't get into our nostalgia unless we look the part. So we are going to ready ourselves to transport back to 2001, okay? Again, pre 9/11, 2001. So I'm gonna try to get as close to a look that I would have done in 2001. So 2001, I was a sophomore in high school. That's grade 10 for those of you who are in Canada. But you probably already know that because y'all know more about America than we know about Canada or Europe or literally anywhere in the world. So I tried to get as close to my look as possible. And we'll see what transpires. So first of all, I'm just gonna use the, I don't know why my foundation continues to explode. It just explodes. It just sits in my bag of makeup and explodes every day, a little more. Every day, another species.
And it's like every 5 minutes, another species.
I would not have used this brand in high school. But foundation is fucking expensive, so I didn't really feel the need to get a new foundation just to prove myself. Instead, I'm gonna apply it the way I would have applied it in the year 2001. A year, I'm using you. I do have a mirror, but I'm gonna use this. So no, you know, moisturizing or anything. We're just gonna get down to the nitty gritty of putting this on our face skin. Is it blended? Nobody gives a shit. Definitely don't do under your chin or your neck. You want there to be a stark difference between the skin on your face that clearly has product on it and the skin on your neck and chin, which does not. What can I wipe my fucking hands on? Why were we like this? Now, being that I was what was known then as a tomboy, and I know that term is not necessarily correct to use these days, but I don't know how else to describe it, okay? Because I don't think I'm a non-binary person. I've never really explored that part of my brain, but I definitely played a lot of sports. I was definitely very sporty. I was a t-shirt girly, but I also, like, once in a while was like,
ooh, glitter.
And then I'd put glitter all over myself, but it looked dumb because I played a lot of sports. So whatever the hell you'd call that, great. I even, for the sake of this video, thinned out my eyebrows, okay? Now granted, I did a little bit more of an arch in high school, but we definitely didn't fill them in because that didn't come about until I think I was in my 20s before I started doing that, but you know what? I look like a nightmare without some color. So we're just gonna do our best. Why don't I use the mirror? Oh my god. 2001, what a year. 2001 was the year where I had homeroom right before lunch, which was dope because my homeroom was on the third floor. And the third floor was where we all smoked a lot of weed. It was funny because our bathrooms didn't have doors. So like we'd have like the paraprofessionals or whatever the hell you called them back in the day. They would just be standing outside the door getting a contact high. So good for us. Good for us. Okay, great. So my brows are done. Wouldn't have even bothered in high school. So next on the list would be probably some blush because you want color on your face. So we gotta dig to find it first. But when we do, you're not even gonna believe. I believe I can fly. Cheekers, gorgeous. And you do not need any other brush than the one that it comes with. It's the perfect applicator, does the job. It looks like this. Can you see it? Yeah, that's what it looks like. Great, right? And we're really just gonna kind of cake this on. There's a little bit of fallout, but we don't know what that is because it's 2001. And we're just gonna apply it to the apples of our cheeks like really aggressively. Just like really fucking aggressively. And maybe like a little too much, but what is too much, you know? So, and just apply very liberally to the apples of your cheeks. You want to smile to find the apples of your cheeks. And smiling is something you're not used to because you're 15 and everything is terrible. Don't forget your nose because that's something your mom does. Skin's looking flawless, looking beautiful, loving it, loving it, loving it.
I understand you've got some cooking tips for us, Diane.
Now, a most important part of an early 2000s, like late 90s, early 2000s specifically, look is cream, shimmery eyeshadow. So I have one from Revlon here. This is what I'm using. Do you see it? This is Revlon Colorstay Cream Eyeshadow in Vanilla, which pretty much sums me up. Let's be serious. This is what we use to let the boys know we're ready to fucking party, okay? So you're just gonna dip your finger right in it. See, like you just, see, look. You really wanna just coat that shit on, okay? Like, I'm not joking. I'm not mincing words here when I say I want you to coat the shit all over your eyelid. Cause like when you first put it on, you're not really gonna be able to see it at all. Okay. But that's why you just keep applying it until you can see it. You really want to get it all the way up to your brow bone too. That's a very important part. Now I'm going to mix these because I'm not fully satisfied with the pigment of this. I feel like back in the day, it used to be much more pronounced. Very, very easy to see. Don't forget the inner corner, okay? Now, the inner corner is important because it's supposed to highlight, you know, your eyes. But, like, the real important thing is that it looks like you're a little greasy. So, stick with what you know. And just for good measure, up in here, we're just gonna add a little bit more. Just to make sure the boys know that when we go to a party, we're down to play 7 Minutes in Heaven. And we'll probably give you a hand in high school. Not as adults. Next, we are going to need something that is like the most important thing to a girl in the early 2000s. And all through the 2000s for that matter. Black liner. Not liquid. Crayon, preferably pencil. And we're just going to go right in And we're going to line the top the best that we can because it's kind of impossible to do. And just make sure the top is there. Like, it doesn't have to be good. It just has to be there, you know? Just like me at school. My high school had the best nachos in the world. Like, I still think about them. I don't think about high school often, but when I do, it's about nachos. If you're really fancy, you'd get your lighter and you'd light this up a little bit and melt it down so that it's got staying power and gets dark and all that stuff. But we're not interested in any of that. But we are gonna fuck up our waterline real good. I've never done this one-handed, and quite frankly, I'm impressed with how good I am at it. You also want these to meet, like, in your outer tear duct or whatever the fuck the corner part of your eye is called. Basically, you just want your eyeliner to be dark, okay? It's just very important. I don't have any Maybelline Great Lash on hand right now. All I have is Fenty Beauty. But I'm going to apply it like I would have as a 15-year-old. And just a reminder that if you're 15 now or like you were 15 recently, you've got it easy. No, you don't. In the makeup department, you do. But just do the bare minimum. They don't have to look good or even. Again, they just have to be there. So we're almost done with the makeup look. But we need one more thing that'll really bring this whole look together. Lip gloss. Because in the early 2000s, if you didn't look wet at all times. Anyway. All right, now we have our face on. That was important. Now we need to know what our hair looks like. So, I brought a few options, okay? I have a clip in my hair, which is fine. I could go back to that, and I probably will. But let's try something different, okay? Let's try... I don't know if this look is for me. I do like the barrette. It does give, like, a... No, I don't smoke weed and... in homeroom kind of thing. But I don't know that that's me because I did smoke a lot of weed in homeroom. I had these things, these little motherfuckers, which my mother always told me were very easy to put in your hair. And okay, so they are. But what is that look? What is that? Nobody wants that. That's a no from me, dog. These were a challenge because I have what is commonly known as horse hair. So my hair doesn't quite fit. I'm not even gonna try it. And then last but not least, I have this, which, you know, allegedly works. So it pulls apart like this, and you're supposed to be able to it's fine. It is what it is. Great. You look great. You look good. We're gonna add a choker to the mix. Y'all have seen these before, no matter what generation you're from. These were so ubiquitous in the 1990s that I think we all know. Well, don't get in the way of my other choker, you little bitch. Okay, so we got that. I've got some cotton candy body spray, which I feel like is a little bit more my vibe. Cover up the weed smell, you know? And we've done it. We're ready to jump back into 2001. May, specifically, of 2001. Hey. I'm ready.
Let's go, girls.
You already know where we're at. You already know what we're doing. We're here. We're queer. We didn't know it yet. The year 2001. Have I been saying 2021 this whole time? We're gonna peruse almost all of this. And, you know, if you were there, you get to live vicariously through your own memories if you weren't there. You get to live vicariously through me. And honestly, I'm sorry for both. Let's crack this puppy open. For those of you who are very young, this is a magazine. Imagine if I just made like a whole condescending video. By the way, these are people who were famous. But let's look at this cover. We've got Pink with her pink hair. Good stuff. I don't like this choker. It's bothering me. It probably would have bothered me in high school too, so it's just more authentic this way. We've got Great Skin, How to Glow All Summer Long, Fashion and Beauty Seals under $25, and Amazing Swimsuits for Every Shape. But we're only going to show you the small one. So let's hop in. This is a Gap ad, and it just says fling. This one should just say flung. Oh, it's an ad for Dawson's Creek. Joey and Pacey and Dawson and what was Michelle Williams? Jen? Was it Jen? Ooh, look at it. There's a Maybelline Lucky Looks instant win game. Should I enter? One time I won $1,000 shopping spree from like a scratch off that I got with a receipt from something I bought at the mall. Only there was nothing identifying where it came from. So I don't know what happened there. Look, Faith Hill. Looking fly. Oh, look, it's Tara Reid. Where is Tara Reid? It says Tara Reid hits our hot list for the first time. And I'm assuming the last because I don't know where the fuck Tara Reid went. Ah, yes. Gather round, children. It's the foundation that we apply only with our hands. Oh, look. Remember Tom Green? It's okay if you don't. But I do think that this headband look needs to come back into style. I said what I said. Look, early 2000s skincare. Clean and clear and crap in a bottle. Perfume samples in magazines or get the fuck out. Should we smell it? It's Clinique Happy, so I kind of already know what it smells like. But let's let it take us back. Doesn't smell really like anything. It's almost like it's been 22 years and that's a long time. Oh, fuck yeah. Charlie's Angels is coming out on VHS and DVD. Oh my god. You can rent it on VHS and DVD, but you can own it only on DVD. That's very confusing for some reason. Gather round, children. This is the foundation we applied with the squishy brush that came with it. It's a sponge. I called it a brush. I'm 15. I don't know the difference. Look at this. Ad for Caboodles. It's encouraging kids to sneak out. Oh my goodness. That mom looks like such a bitch. Look at her. She's like,
I bet that's not even Amanda sleeping in that bed.
But
jelly roll pens.
Those were the best. I had so many. My best friends and I kept a notebook that we passed back and forth between classes, and we all had different colors of jelly roll pens. And my friend Carrie always had the best ones. So I stole them all the time. No, I'm just kidding. Hot topic. Abstinence sex ed, does it really work? I'm gonna read some of these to you. Everyone knows that sex is safer with protection. But even then, there's risk of pregnancy or contracting a sexually transmitted disease. Abstinence is the only method that keeps teens 100% safe, and that's why it should be the focus of what schools teach. Adding other elements into the mix just sends us muddled messages. Teens already have enough to learn about. Sex is one experience that can wait. As a virgin, I think it's best to wait until marriage because intercourse is something special that should be shared only with someone you really trust. Abstinence-only education isn't just an alternative. It's the best way to keep teens from getting pregnant.
When the abstinence hits.
So that was by Kirk Hawkins, age 19. And, I'm sorry, sir, are you late for your Jehovah Witness meeting, or? My friend told me she was pregnant over Christmas break of my senior year of high school. I'll never forget that night. She sounded so scared and embarrassed, and I was shocked. I knew that she and her boyfriend were having sex, but I never thought she would become pregnant.
Never.
Luckily, her parents were ready to support any decision she made. She considered options like abortion and adoption, but in the end, she decided to keep the baby. While I spent that year looking forward to the prom, graduation, and college, she was about to become a mother. I watched as her friends drifted away from her. Even though I tried to stay close to her, it was hard because our lives were taking different paths. She had the baby after graduation. Now, while all her friends are in college, she's living at home with her parents and her child. When I see what my friend went through, I know that by remaining a virgin for now, I'm not only protecting myself from the physical consequences, but the emotional ones as well. I'm certain my friend is a good mother, but she also missed out on being a teen.
Wow, Diana Rossetto, age 19, from Wayside, New Jersey.
Sounds like you weren't getting any in high school.
These kiddos must have been shell-shocked 8 years later when 16 and pregnant came onto the scene.
Telling someone, especially a teen, not to do something doesn't necessarily mean they'll listen, which makes sex education essential. Teens have sex for two reasons, curiosity and libido, and while we can't prevent our hormones from raging by learning about the negative as well as the positive aspects of sex, we might be less likely to try and find things out through experimentation. Of course, abstinence is an important concept, but it shouldn't be the only part of the curriculum. Since schools have the opportunity to educate thousands of teens, they shouldn't waste it by omitting crucial information that we might not be getting anywhere else. Besides, sex is a fact of life, neither dirty nor bad, as abstinence-only education can make it seem. Teaching us about sex, including the physical and emotional repercussions, may not stop all teens from doing it, but it can help us make a wise, well-informed decision. Christy Scatton, 16, from Hazeltown, Pennsylvania. I assume you went places in life. The other two probably voted for Donald Trump. Look, Tiger Woods! We're in the Star Tracks portion now. And as you can see here, we've got Justin and Mary J. Blige and Brittany and Auntie Steven Tyler. I assume this is when Moby met his extended family. Look, this is when Fred Durst was still invited to things. Look, Julia Stiles is going to college, but not Juilliard. While appearing on CNN's Larry King Live, NSYNC touched on topics ranging from taking dance lessons to the status of their love lives. When teased about their largely female fan base, why would you be teased about that? They all want to fuck you. Justin Timberlake replied, "You wouldn't enjoy millions of girls screaming, Larry, Larry, Larry." Shut up, Justin. Lance Bass take this one. For real though, we should bring back this haircut. Like, this choppy ass short hair is the hair that I wished I could have had as a kid, because my hair doesn't do that. Again, I have horse hair. How about Sarah Michelle Gellar and Freddie Prinze Jr. winning a prom king and queen of the millennial generation? How about that time that Julia Roberts was really excited because Jennifer Aniston was super pissed? Time that Kate Hudson made this face for some reason. Oh my god, Lana got coned! And this was before everybody thought Anne Hathaway was a cunt. Do you remember Charlotte Church? Do you remember Charlotte Church? Wyclef. Ben Affleck and Matt Damon teamed up in LA to meet the finalists for Project Greenlight, their contest for struggling screenwriters. The winner, Pete Jones, a Chicagoan living in LA, will direct a film based on his script, Stolen Summer. Stolen Summer. You mean Stolen Summer, starring the Bonnie Hunt? There's actually a lot of lore about that. I don't even remember what the situation was. It was like Project Greenlight was like a thing, but it wasn't a thing. And like they were making a movie, but they didn't know that they were making a movie about making a movie. So there's like a documentary within it about making the movie that like none of the actors were like privy to. It was kind of crazy. What is going on with this Evian ad? Oh, check it out. Noxzema, it burns. I should have been their marketing team. For 1 year, they were given cameras to capture their hopes, their fears, and their high school. These are their stories. And now none of them will put the fucking cameras away.
I think this was for a document. Yes, this was for a documentary called American High, which I only vaguely remember and I did not ever watch. But it was like
one of the early forays into like reality television, which is interesting. No actors, no scripts, just life. Should I track this down? Because this is, again, pre 9/11 high school. It's post like Columbine. Not that I'm like looking to bring up all the tragedies, but like it's just interesting how much school has to have changed. Like, I remember the pre 9/11 days, okay? Ooh, Craig David. It just says the first line. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. First line just says, "Naughty Craig David." Why is he so naughty? He was only 19 in 2001? Holy God. That guy sure knew the days of the week. Now, cyber sightseeking. Looking for the latest on J-Lo? The best celeb sites are run by those who know them. They're fans. First of all, fan sites were the best. You could find the coolest shit, the best photos, all of it. I don't even think I can describe why they were the best. They just were. Find me on GeoCities, okay? Freddie Prinze Jr. site, ilovefreddie.com. Webmaster, Josephine High, 15, from British Columbia. Downloadable Freddie wallpaper, a photo gallery, and his the latest on his films like Summer Catch and Scooby-Doo. ilovefreddie.com. Me during my Nightmare on Elm Street phase. Okay. One. This ad triggers my trypophobia so bad. Two, this young woman is very happy to be in a tub full of milk and cereal. And three, I hate it. What to check out this month now? Movies, vampires, mummies, and spies. Oh my. Oh my. Spy Kids. It comes out on March 30th. Or it came out on March 30th. And you know, who knew 20 some years later, we'd know so much about one of the cast members. Where did Erica Christensen go? Ooh, a Stetson ad. Ooh, that one is strong. And it smells like my youth. Ooh. My nipple just got hard. Just the one. What? I don't want to find out on teenpeople.com. That feels like none of my business. What is this? What is this? This is like, it's called Toe Jam. And it's like labels. I wonder if it still exists. I'm gonna get like somebody's freaky ass OnlyFans or something. Is it just toejam.com? It's not bringing up any results, so we'll see what happens, I guess. Ooh, beauty trends. Fun. Fun. There's like a lot of pretty familiar brands. You know, you've got your Bobbi Brown down here. You've got Hard Candy up there. This is a NARS, this big one here. It's really interesting because like brands like that, like makeup and beauty brands and stuff, were not something that I was terribly into or even very much aware of. I really didn't care. I used my mother's like old ass Maybelline, you know, trios and quads. And then like around like 12, 13, when I was able to go to the mall with my friend by myself, we would get like makeup and glitter and stuff from Limited Too. But like I said, I was whatever iteration, whatever you would call a tomboy today, that was me as a kid. So like I didn't pay very close attention to things like brands and labels because it just wasn't important to me. So I was very interested to see that a lot of these like Clarins, Benefit, all of these, like they've been around a long time. And then that's probably not news to you, but it was news to me. Belts were mandatory. Whether you had like a studded belt or a spiky belt or a canvas belt, you had to be wearing a belt or your outfit was stupid. And it seems, judging by this page, that camo got really popular right before 9/11. Feels like
foreshadowing propaganda. Also, gather round, children. We went through a big visor phase. And when I say we, I mean anyone but me, because I'm not Guy Fieri, and this is not Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. Why is May 22nd the release date of Shrek not a national holiday, for fuck's sake? Oh, Star Wars. I love hearing just horrifying stories. Here's one from The Rock.
I have no problem wrestling in a $500 shirt and ripping it off after a win. Once I had a flashy shirt on and I really kicked ass. We were going off the air and I was getting the cue because...
Yeah, in case you didn't know, if you're young, and this isn't me being condescending, this is just adding context. If you didn't know, The Rock used to be a wrestler before he was an endearing actor.
We were going off the air and I was getting the cue. 30 seconds, Rock, I was on the top rope and I started trying to rip my shirt off.
Me, when I'm on the top rope trying to rip my shirt off?
When I'm into it, I can break any button, or so I thought. I kept pulling on the sleeves and everyone was looking. Then, with about 5 seconds left, I finally got one arm out. It was live TV, and there was nothing I could do.
I'm surprised you went on after that. Oh, Rachel Lee Cook.
Several years ago, I was at the Hollywood Reporter Young Star Awards, presenting with James Marsden from the 1990s sitcom Step by Step. Before we announced the nominees, I'd already started opening the envelope. Jason had to nudge me and say, Rachel, I think we should announce the nominees. I was like, oh, sorry, I got excited.
I can't believe you didn't kill yourself. Ask us. Advice. No, ask me instead. I'm 37. You can trust me. Let's see. We're just going to read the headlines. We're not going to even read the whole thing. And I'm just going to give advice based on the headlines. I found out that my best friend's boyfriend cheated on her. I want to tell her, but I'm friends with him too. What should I do? You narc him the fuck out. It's called girl code, bitch. I'm 16 and I get my period only 4 times a year. Is something wrong with me? Only in the sense that everything's wrong with you. Do condoms give you twice the protection? Twice the protection and none of the sensation. I know this probably sounds weird, but I feel like I'm too smart for a lot of guys and I scare them away. I feel like there's something wrong with me. What can I do? You can become an excellent lesbian. Sometimes I get erections out of the blue. Even when I'm not thinking about anyone. Is this normal? No. God, did I mention how much I loved these choppy ass fucking haircuts? Because I really did, and I wished that I could have one. Oh, okay. Here, listen to me. If you're in high school currently, or you're about to head into high school, and they're still trying to scam you with these fucking high school rings, let me save you like a bunch of time and tons of money. It's a waste. Because unless you fucking peaked in high school and the rest of your life is downhill, you're not gonna want to really remember that much of high school. And also, if you're like me, you probably lost it before you even graduated. Ooh, live with LFO, a listening party. Why are most of these guys dead? All right. Shooby-doo-wop and Scooby snacks. Really take it out of you. Okay, well, here's an ad that I think we can all agree on. A guy is butt-ass naked. And it just says, lost your snow gear? Lost your snow gear? Get naked and drink Sprite. What are you about, Sprite? Is that why it's so fucking spicy? Ooh, a test. Be honest. You already know. I need something to write with. I don't have a pen. All right, I'm going to try to answer as, like, me from 2001, okay? Where'd my eyeliner go? I could use that. That'll be fun. Nothing matters. I'm going to graduate. I'm just going to move to New York City. Okay, one. If they canceled school for a day, what would you do? A, read your favorite book. B, play sports. C, help around the house. Or D, go out with your friends. I would go out with my friends. Are you fucking kidding me? Get the fuck out of here. Help around the house. What's your favorite music? A, alternative, rock, electronica. Those are three very different things. B, rap and hip hop. C, pop and world music. Those again are two different things. D, love songs and ballads. Oh my god, I loved all of them though. Probably in high school, 2001. Where were you in 2001? You were listening to a lot of John Mayer. You were listening, probably pop. We're just gonna say pop. If you could make your dreams come true, you'd A, be the world champion of your favorite sport. B, be voted most popular in school. C, work at a space center. That is very fucking specific. D, get a date with the cutest girl/guy in class.
these are the dreams I have to choose from. Can we, like, broaden our horizons? I guess get a date with the cutest girl / guy in class? For a party, you put on A, something original and wild, even if it doesn't look that great. I think that's just the answer. B, the latest fashions. C, something classic. It's better safe than sorry. Yeah, you don't want to be sorry that you wore something that wasn't classic. D, something like what your friends are going to wear. I'm going to say A because I was a very unique person. Not now. Now, basic aside. Your favorite kind of movie is A, romance. B, comedy. C, action adventure. D, horror. Probably horror. Let's see. Let's add up our points. I got 12 points total. How'd you do? You don't know. You can't. You don't have this in front of you. Okay, 12 points. You're outgoing yet sensitive. No. And you're totally social. No. You like people and people like you. No. You already know you don't need a cigarette to fit in. Oh my god, is this a don't smoke advertisement? I was already smoking a pack a day by then. These tests really aren't good for anything. What are you gonna wear tonight? Cigarettes. No thanks. Loser, you don't wear cigarettes. Please don't smoke. I smoked for way too long and you shouldn't do it at all. Just don't do it unless you really want to fit in. Work 101, the first day. Ooh. Nothing seems more confusing than starting a new job. Yeah, you ever have to teach yourself how to play Minesweeper? That's pretty confusing. But it doesn't have to be that way. Teen People rounded up these top tips for having a stress-free day one. Dress to impress. You need to know the company's style to fit in, said that guy who wrote that book. Well, pink hair may not go over well at a bank. It might be fine at a record store. So read the room. Got it. Study for the W-4. The key is figuring out your personal allowances, a short list of criteria, such as determining whether you're a dependent, which the government uses to decide how much tax should be taken out of your check. Don't avoid taxes. Get a job that's off the books. That's bad news. Not only is it illegal, but if you get hurt at work, it can be more difficult to obtain compensation for your injury. Anybody reading this magazine is going to work at, like, fucking Deb or, like, The Limited or, like, Checkers or something. But it's really nice that they have this whole checklist because these are things that you can learn from magazines that nobody taught you in school. Did you know that Eli Whitney invented the cotton gin? Oh, fun. Look at it. Salon Selectives. If you're old enough to know, Salon Selectives, leave a comment down below saying you're ancient because we both are. And there's that, like, spiky ass choppy hair that I loved so much. Now we've reached the 25 hottest stars under 25. Hey, JC. JC, Rod Stewart called. He would like his hair back. You know, I feel like I've said this a lot, but, like, where did Cisco go? Is he dead? Did he die? Was it a death by thong? We're gonna be back to poke fun at Cisco very soon. And that's all I'm gonna say about that. Always leave him wanting more. James King, 21. When did James King become Jamie King? When did she change her name? I don't really care. I'm just asking. Asking for a friend. James, who recently broke up with boyfriend Kid Rock. Did I know that? Has come a long way in the 4 years since she kicked a heroin habit that plagued her early modeling career. I did not know that. We learn something new every day from Teen People and only Teen People. Oh, Freddie Prinze Jr., America's millennial prom king. He just started dating Sarah Michelle Gellar last year. And the couple is currently playing house in the San Fernando Valley. They're still together. Shakira! Who knew? Just 22-ish years, we'd be trying to get Tom Cruise to leave her alone. Mandy Moore being natural. Remember when we thought this was skincare? Like, tippity tap. Good stuff. Oh, this is shampoo and conditioner. Remember when I could read?
I understand you've got some cooking tips for us, Diane.
Okay, so we had JC, Rod Stewart, Shazay on the first page, right? And on the cover. So I like that we're going separately with the members of NSYNC. and that we've left out fucking Chris Kirkpatrick. Chris didn't quite make the cut. All the other members of NSYNC did, but not Chris. It's not wrong, but, like, it's cruel. Look, it's Goldie Hawn's daughter. This time last year, Oscar voters knew her as Goldie Hawn's daughter. Natural. Aww, look at baby Jessica. No, wait, baby Jessica was the one that fell in that well. Never mind. Cute top. Billy Gilman. It's Billy Gilman. I was 14 when this issue came out, and I am still not sure what he's all about. But I am sure that these ads are getting more and more natural. And I assume on this ad, this is just the white background is just a very, very zoomed in photo of Mandy Moore's teeth. Oh, look, it's Britney before we were all very, very concerned. Look, it's Julia Stiles again. Julia Stiles knows how to party. Just ask Bogey Lowenstein.
Must be Nigel with the brie.
Or the scouts at Juilliard. Who the hell is this? And who held her up at gunpoint for her to wear this jacket? I think some people went on the island just to pursue careers in entertainment. Says first season survivor Colleen Haskell. Oh, she's from Survivor. Hopefully she survived that jacket. Natural! Now featuring lip gloss.
I'm missing you like tender.
Oh, look, it's Destiny's Child. Beyonce, she's Beyonce, you know. You know Beyonce. Kelly, she did that song with Nelly. And Michelle. AJ McLean, when I was growing up, I did my own thing. Cool. It's still the same way. That explains the lip piercing, those 20 tattoos. He's aiming for 23. One for each birthday candle. And his fierce determination to stand apart from the other boys. AJ's one-man posse, as he calls it, has had a standout year. Natural, but smaller. For real, like, where is Tara Reid? Anyone seen her? Anyone? Frankie Muniz, didn't he just win some, like, big race? He's like a race car driver now, right? Like Lightning McQueen? He's like Lightning McQueen now. Ka-chow. Look! Natural. But with hands. I remember when Skechers were like almost cool. And like not the orthopedic shoe that your Aunt Linda wears just to feel something. Oh, look, it's a tampon ad. Look at, we got a tampon ad here. Let's read it. So this girl, Missy, she's walking into class, okay? And there's a class. Her seat's all the way back there. Okay.
Kickin'. An empty seat right next...
Kickin'? Really? Did we say that?
Kickin'!
An empty seat right next to the class hottie. Talk about luck. This is like a total jackpot.
I just hope my pad jumps in on this lucky streak. Right now it feels like it might just jump ship instead. Like, hey, who knew it would be this kind of day anyway? Besides, this was the only kind of pad in my locker. With the right one, I'd be strolling over there like Little Miss Thing. Well, time for the klutz act again. Quick, drop the books to distract him and make a break for that seat. Man, where's that fire drill when you need it?
Missy, could you sit down? You've just been having like a stream of consciousness at the front of the room for about 20 minutes. It's time for algebra. Excuse me, but who let Shannon Elizabeth out? I thought we had an agreement. I hope Shannon Elizabeth hasn't survived like a kidnapping or something in the past 20 years. I will feel really bad for that joke. A whole article about Tom Green? This bathing suit. This was the beginning of the tankini, okay? And Old Navy was flooded with them. There were so many kinds of tankinis. For those of us who had sad bod. Look at it. I was so correct. Look. It's from Old Navy. $11 each. $11? Holy shit. I had this bathing suit. I had this one. I had it before I got sad bought. Oh my God, look at this. Then and now, Julia Roberts. I think we all know this page would give Julian Solomita a headache. And while that's hilarious, they're all Julia Roberts. No one on this page is Sandra Bullock or Anne Hathaway. For whatever reason, platinum SJP, we've got, look at, is baby Sarah Paulson. Her and Winona Ryder during her stealing stuff era. Natural, but in a jumpsuit. So Elisa Donovan looks younger now than she did then. I think I found my favorite thing in this entire magazine. Carson Daly's Got Milk ad. Got Milk ads were always weird, but like, look at that face. Natural.
LOL, I can play football because of my Playtex tampons.
And puka shells. Horoscopes. I'm gonna read my horoscope and then I'm gonna read my crush's horoscope. Capricorn. You're some piece of work. Hey, I didn't expect to be called out today. Signs say you're putting yourself under reconstruction in an effort to become the person you've always imagined yourself to be, but lacked the guts to embody. You now find the courage to defeat self-doubt, determined to manifest your full potential. I feel like all of my horoscopes for the past 37 years have said that. Let's read my crushes. He's a Leo. Gray matter. Gross. The world isn't as black and white as you perceive it, Leo. Although, it would be funny if his name was Leo. He was a Leo. His name isn't Leo, okay. Although you do tend to categorize people, those you encounter now won't slip easily into a neatly labeled box. You see that good people do bad things, and vice versa. It's time to outgrow those signature snaps to judgment. Why are these horoscopes yelling at us? Let's read this interview with Ja Rule. I'm gonna do my best Ja Rule impression, okay? Teen People asks, what inspired Put It On Me, the new single?
Women were making I Don't Need...
I can't do it. It's going to hurt my throat.
Women were making I Don't Need a Man, I'm Independent records, and men were making booty records. Shaky ass girl, I'm big pimpin'. So I wanted to hit them with something different. I was out in LA making my album for 3 months and I got homesick for my girlfriend, Aisha. She was the inspiration.
You've already made a film, 2000's Turn It Up. Your second, the street racing gang flick, The Fast and the Furious, hits theaters in June. How did you prepare for this movie? I didn't prepare like I should have. I play Edwin Bishop, a trash-talking racer, and I thought I knew something about racing because a lot of friends of mine street race. So I go over to the set thinking I know, but I don't know anything about spark plugs. Are you at all like Bishop? I like fast cars, but I don't want to soup up a Nissan and go 180 miles per hour. I just love Ja Rule. And then there's like the whole back page is just old photos of Jennifer Aniston and her Rachel haircut. So that brings us to the end. I feel taken back to a time before there was a constant breaking news ticker at the bottom of every single television station, including the Disney Channel. I enjoyed embodying what I must have looked like in high school. And I hope you enjoyed this too. There's a lot more nostalgia content coming. I hope you enjoyed this. And if you didn't, cool. Thanks for watching. I appreciate you being here. Like the video if you want to. Subscribe if you want to. Do whatever you want if you want to. I haven't made a video in a minute. I forgot my whole ass outro. Channel memberships and Patreon, social media, Amazon storefront. All the links to all the things are down below. Thanks so much for watching. If you stay, I don't know if there's outtakes, but if there are, stay tuned for them. I'll see you next one. Bye. I'm not like other girls.